afternoon.
Good afternoon, Father.
And happy Father's Day. Also, happy summer solstice. It's been over 3 months since I've been here, so if I make mistakes or anything, please don't be offended. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And my sisters and brothers, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you are the healing hand of God. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are the way to holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the divine presence whom we seek. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may always revere and love your holy name, for you never deprive of your guidance those you set firm on the foundation of your love, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Jeremiah said, I hear the whisperings of many, terror on every side. Denounce, let us denounce him. All those who were my friends are on watch for any misstep of mine. Perhaps he will be trapped. Then we can prevail and take our vengeance on him. But the Lord is with me like a mighty champion. My prosecutors will stumble. They will not triumph. In their failure, they will be put to utter shame, to lasting, unforgettable confusion. O Lord of hosts, you test the just who probe mind and heart. Let me witness the vengeance you take on them. For to you, I have entrusted my cause. Sing to the Lord, praise the Lord, for he has rescued the life of the poor from the power of the wicked. The word of the Lord. Our response tonight is, Lord, in your great love, answer me. For your sake I bear insult, and shame covers my face. I have become an outcast to my brothers, a stranger to my mother's children. Because zeal for your house consumes me, and the insults of those who blaspheme, you fall upon me. Lord, in your great love, answer me. I pray to you, O Lord, for the time of your favor, O God. In your great kindness, answer me. With your constant help, answer me, O Lord, for the bounteous is your kindness, and your great mercy turns towards me.
Lord, your
great love, answer me. See your lonely ones and be glad. You who seek God, may your hearts revive. For For the Lord hears the poor, and his own who are in bond he spurns not. Let the heaven and earth praise him, the sea and whatever moves in them. The Lord, in your great love, answer me. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, through one man sin entered the world, and through sin death. And thus death came to all men, inasmuch as all sinned. For up to the time of the law, sin was in the world. Through sin is not accounted when there is no law. But death reigned from Adam to Moses, even over those who did not sin. After the pattern of trespass of Adam, who is the type of one who was to come. But the gift is not like the transgression. For if by the transgression of the one the many died, how much more did the grace of God and the gracious gift of the one man, Jesus Christ, overflow for the many? The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Your blessing, Father.
May the Lord be in your heart and on your lips, that you may proclaim this gospel worthily and well, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Alleluia, alleluia. The Spirit of truth will testify to me, says the Lord, and you also will testify. Alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to the 12, "Fear no one. Nothing is concealed that will not be revealed, nor secret that will not be known. What I say to you in the darkness, speak in the light. What you hear whispered, proclaim on the housetops. And do not be afraid of those who kill the body, but cannot kill the soul. Rather, be afraid of the one who can destroy both soul and body in Gehenna. Are not two sparrows sold for a small coin? Yet not one of them falls to the ground without your Father's knowledge. Even all the hairs of your head are counted. So do not be afraid. You are worth more than many sparrows. Everyone who acknowledges me before others, I will acknowledge before my Heavenly Father. But whoever denies me before others, I will deny before my Heavenly Father." The Gospel of the Lord.
Once again, happy Father's Day weekend. Father's Day is a perfect time to reflect upon St. Joseph. A few years ago, I made a private retreat at Holy Hill. Holy Hill is a basilica and national shrine of Mary, Help of Christians, near Hubertus, northwest of Milwaukee. Holy Hill has been a place of pilgrimage for my family for three or more generations, and likewise for many other people. According to the Holy Hill website, about 300,000 visitors stop there annually. When my dad's father, my grandfather, was in his 30s, he fell off a load of hay and broke his leg. My father was an adolescent at the time, and he remembered the accident well. My grandfather promised that if his leg would heal, he would walk from his farm in Sauk County to Holy Hill. His leg healed, and he kept his promise to walk the approximately 100 miles to Holy Hill. But he took the train for the trip back. My mother also remembered visiting Holy Hill as a young girl and experiencing angel food cake for the first time. And this was also during a trip to Holy Hill. She and her sister, who was about 15 months older than my mother, at first thought the angel food cake was white bread until they tasted it. But back to my retreat at Holy Hill a few years ago, because this was a private, undirected retreat, I took reading and writing material with me. I arrived at Holy Hill midday on Tuesday and left at 6 o'clock on Friday morning, thus spending about 2.5 days at Holy Hill. On Wednesday and Thursday mornings, I concelebrated Mass with a retired Carmelite priest in residence, and little did I know that he was the author of a number of books and on St. Joseph, and also the editor of a book entitled St. Joseph and the Third Millennium. After Mass on the second day, he offered me a memento, namely a copy of his book on St. Joseph. The book was printed in 1999 in time for the new millennium and consists of a series of articles on St. Joseph by various authors. Back in my room, I eagerly opened the book, and I was delighted to find an article by the world-famous scripture scholar, Father Raymond Brown. Not only was I happy about finding an article by Father Raymond Brown, but the article dealt with my favorite passage of the New Testament, the opening verses of St. Matthew's Gospel, the genealogy of Jesus through his legal father, Joseph. One of my hobbies is genealogy, incidentally. At Holy Hill, the altar in the side chapel off the main church has an artistic rendering of the family tree of Jesus as found in the beginning of the Gospel of Matthew. All those difficult to pronounce names are on the altar front, interwoven into the branches of a vine or a tree. During retreat, I had the time to actually count the names using the exercise as a meditation. And yes, all of them are on the altar front. In reflecting upon the few passages in the Gospel where St. Joseph is noted, one can't help but wonder if he didn't experience fear as noted in the Gospel assigned for today, and even the terror noted by Jeremiah in today's first reading. Joseph had some major issues to deal with: Mary's pregnancy, the birth of Jesus, their flight into Egypt to escape Herod, Jesus being accidentally left at the temple when he was 12 years old. These few issues noted in the Gospel of Matthew and Luke, in the Gospels of Matthew and Luke, are some of the major events. In the day-to-day living, there must have been many other issues for the Holy Family, just as there are in any other family. From the Gospels, we learn that Joseph was a carpenter. At one point in the Gospels, Jesus is referred to as the carpenter's son in an attempt to discredit him. And in another place, a potential disciple of Jesus asks if anything good can come from Nazareth. Near Nazareth in Jesus' day was a major city named Sepphoris, which is no longer in existence. Nazareth, in today's terminology, may have been a bedroom community of this large city. This city of Sepphoris was only a few miles from Nazareth and was once the capital city of Galilee. About the time of Jesus' birth, this major city, probably within view of Nazareth, was mostly destroyed by the Romans after a riot took place there. During Jesus' lifetime, this major city was in the process of being rebuilt. So it is no stretch of the imagination that Joseph and Jesus would have found work there. But the point I'm trying to make is that Jesus and Joseph had to make a living by work and probably commuted to work like many people do today. The gospel assigned for today, this 12th Sunday in Ordinary Time, reminds one that the God who knows the number of hairs on one's head will surely care for us through any difficulty. And this is good to remember as we face physical illness, financial troubles, and other concerns, either our own or those of others. Let us profess our faith together. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us humbly and prayerfully place our concerns in God's care.
We pray for Pope Francis, Bishop Donald, and all pastors and the faithful, that we may continue to work for peace and justice in our world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the grace to be worthy sons and daughters of the Father and of the promise of eternal life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those who put the safety and welfare of others ahead of their own. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all fathers that they may enjoy the love and respect of their families and that they may be good providers for those who depend on them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those preparing our churches for the resumption of Mass, that they may be guided by the Spirit to ensure a spiritual and safe homecoming for all the faithful. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the intention of this Mass, Robert Hoffman, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and the suffering of our parish, for our beloved dead, especially Terry Cleaver, and for all the intentions in our parish book of intentions, and those held in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and of our neighbor, grant that by keeping your precepts we may merit to attain eternal life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all of his
name. Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise, and grant that cleansed by its action, we may make offering of a heart pleasing to you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering canceled out our sins by his rising from the dead. He has opened the way to eternal life, and by sending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with a company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and Donald Joseph, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom of God, the Lord is on earth.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Actually, I'll say the closing prayer in the back, along with a blessing for all fathers. So,
we ask of your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate with constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
This, as I said, this is a special blessing for special blessing prayer for fathers, and then a blessing for all of us present. God, our Father, in your wisdom and love, you made all things. Bless these men that they may be strengthened as Christian fathers. Let the example of their faith and love shine forth. Grant that we, their sons and daughters, may honor them always with a spirit of profound respect. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the blessing of Almighty God be with you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thank you.